According to a crime report for the period 31st December to 2nd January 2024, there was no major security concern recorded in the country. Police spokesperson Fred Enanga revealed that, despite the looming terror threat in the country during this period under review, there was total peace and stability. However, at least 31 people were killed in the 55 incidents reported.
Injured. Out of the 31 lives that were lost, 5 victims were lynched on suspicion of theft. 6 were hacked or stabbed to death. Those are murders by hacking. 4 committed suicide. 2 were suspectedly poisoned to death.
Police notes that during the period under review, murder took the lead, followed by mob justice, and these mainly happened in bars and other social places. The highest cases were recorded in Rwenzori West, North Choga, as well as Aswa policing regions.
Then murders by stabbing and murder by mobs were highest amongst. For instance, out of this breakdown, murder by hackings, 5, murder by mob, 5 suspected murders, 5, fire outbreak, 3, arson, 3, suicide, 2.
During the same period, hundreds of suspects were arrested from across the country. These are yet to be arraigned in courts of law. From the Kampala Metropolitan, over 300 were arrested in operations conducted to crack down on criminality.
A total of 4,649 suspects were in custody, charged with various offences. And out of these, 4,039 were male adults, 242 female adults, 68 male juveniles.
Overall, we have over 300 suspects, but 57 of these were arrested from the Nkuka music festival.
Meanwhile, the police have warned of a new criminal gang targeting city dwellers that are residing in apartments. Police say these are usually armed with machetes and sticks and attack unsuspecting people. Landlords have been advised to put up stronger security measures at their premises.
Where there is a group of thugs that is targeting residents or communities living in apartments. And this now calls for more vigilance by proprietors of these apartments.
From the Directorate of Traffic and Road Safety, at least 26 people died in road crashes on the New Year Eve. Michael Kananura, the traffic police spokesperson, reveals that majority of the crashes were as a result of reckless road usage, driving under the influence of alcohol, among others.
During this period, we registered road crashes where 26 people lost their lives and 62 people sustained serious injuries.
Meanwhile, NERA is planning a mass registration and enrollment exercise as it aims at replacing the expiring national IDs. It emerges that the majority of the national identity cards are expiring this year.
Whereby we shall be registering all of you at parish levels, sub-county levels, for those citizens that have never registered, and even those that have IDs that are about to expire, we shall be able to renew for you.
Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.